Hello. Amazon Cognito Identity Pools enable you to create unique identities for your users and securely federate them with identity providers. Customers leverage Amazon Cognito Identity Pools as a credential broker in order to obtain temporary limited privilege AWS credentials to access AWS resources. Amazon Cognito Identity Pool supports federation with Amazon Cognito User Pools, OpenID Connect and SAML 2.0 identity providers, and social identity providers such as login with Amazon, Facebook, Google, or sign in with Apple. Today, I'm going to walk you through how to create an Amazon Cognito Identity Pool through the new console experience. Within the AWS console, navigate to the Amazon Cognito service. This initial screen might look different if you already have existing user or identity pools in this region. Since we want to grant access to AWS resources, we're going to select that as the business case and click Create Identity Pool. In this first step, you select the sources that your identity pool will trust to generate identities and issue temporary AWS credentials. You can choose between authenticated access, guest access, or both. As an example, an unauthenticated user with guest access may only be able to view generic public information within your application, whereas after a user is authenticated, they would be able to view additional information bound by the temporary access obtained from the Amazon Cognito Identity Pool. We're going to select authenticated access for our example today, which will display all possible identity sources the identity pool can trust in order to exchange the identity provider tokens or assertions for temporary limited privilege AWS credentials. We'll select Amazon Cognito User Pool for the example today. You must select at least one identity provider, but you can select as many identity sources as needed to support your use case. Click Next. In the second step, we're going to configure permissions and set the default IAM role that authenticated users will assume through the Amazon Cognito Identity Pool. For this example, we're going to create a new IAM role. You can also select an existing role. If you previously selected guest access in the first step, you will also have the ability to select the default IAM role that unauthenticated users will assume. You can modify the roles associated with your identity pool in the AWS Identity and Access Management console at any time. Click Next. In this next step, we're going to connect and configure the identity providers we selected in the previous step. In this case, we chose Amazon Cognito User Pool. In this example, we have an existing Amazon Cognito user pool we want to use as the identity provider, so we'll select that. Additionally, select the appropriate app client ID associated with your existing Amazon Cognito user pool. Next, you're going to choose how the identity pool will identify the user's role to assume when the service issues session credentials. You can use the default authenticated role that we configured in the previous step, or choose a role based on user claims and rules. For now, we'll stick with the default authenticated role that we configured previously. After the identity pool is created, you will have the ability to change these configurations in the Cognito Identity Pool console. The last section allows you to configure attributes to be used for access control. In this example, we'll select Use Default Mappings. This will allow claims from the identity provider to be mapped to principal tags that can be used to control access to AWS resources. Amazon Cognito will apply principal tags to your user's temporary session. A separate and unique set of configuration options will be displayed for each additional identity provider you previously selected, such as login with Amazon, sign in with Apple, or any SAML or OpenID Connect provider. It's important to note that if you trust an Amazon Cognito user pool that currently uses third-party identity providers, you only need to configure and establish trust between the Cognito user pool and the Cognito Identity Pool. Click Next. In this next step, we need to create a friendly name for the identity pool. By default, the Enhanced Authentication Flow, also known as the Simplified Flow, is used in order to exchange Amazon Cognito tokens for temporary limited privilege AWS credentials. This is the recommended authentication flow to use. You have the option to also support the basic authentication flow, also known as the classic flow. You would activate the basic authentication flow if your app relies on separate API requests to retrieve an identity token and then assume a role using that token. Lastly, you can create tags for the identity pool. Click Next. The final step in creating an Amazon Cognito identity pool will provide you an opportunity to review all of your selections and confirm everything is correct. If changes are needed, you can select the Edit option next to each respective step. Scroll to the bottom of the page to fully review all selections. After reviewing everything, click the Create Identity Pool button. A notification will be visible at the top of the screen to indicate the successful creation of the identity pool. Now let's walk through the Amazon Cognito Identity Pool in the new console after it's been created. Once opening the identity pool, the default screen will provide an overview of your identity pool and provide some details such as the identity pool name and identity pool ID. There is also some guidance and resources on how to begin using your identity pool, starting with installing the mobile or JavaScript SDK. The first tab displays user statistics such as identities this month, total identities, and a percentage breakdown of unauthenticated versus authenticated access. You can also view some of this data over various timeframes. The Identity Browser tab will allow you to view the identities that have been created in this user pool. The User Access tab will display the identity pool settings for authenticated and unauthenticated access. The Authenticated Access section will display all federated identity providers you have configured to trust with the Cognito Identity Pool. Clicking into each identity provider will allow you to configure what IAM role can be assumed and edit any attribute mappings that can be used for access control. The Guest Access section will indicate whether you have guest access enabled or not and will display what IAM role unauthenticated guest users would assume. Within the Identity Pool Properties tab, you can configure the basic authentication option and update any tags for the identity pool. The Other Properties tab would contain settings that would only be used if you have already adopted Amazon Cognito Sync. In this video, I demonstrated how to create an Amazon Cognito identity pool through the new console experience, including how to select and configure the trusted identity providers, creating default IAM roles to be assumed by authenticated and unauthenticated users, configuring role settings, and configuring attributes that can be used for access control. Lastly, I also walked through the new console experience of an already created Amazon Cognito identity pool. To learn more about Amazon Cognito, visit the service page online at aws.amazon.com/cognito.